Hello guys and welcome to this video. In this video we will learn how to create an animated bottom navigation bar in Flutter. So this is going to be the design that we're aiming for, and we're going to achieve that using the Solimen bottom bar package. So make sure to add this package inside your purposefig.yaml file. Let's go there, and I already have added this package. So after adding the package, make sure to save the file. Also, inside my material app, I'm returning home screen. This is a stateful widget, and it should be. Inside my stateful widget, I have a scaffold with a background color. Every scaffold provides us with a bottom navigation bar property. This is where we define our Solimen bottom bar. So let's do that. Solimen bottom bar requires me a list of items, and this is going to be the list of bottom navigation bar items. I'm going to define it as a list above. Each item has an icon and also a title. So the first icon I'm going to put is a home screen. We also need to provide a title, and this is a widget, so I'm providing a text. Let's also make sure this is constant. So I'm going to copy it a couple of more times. And for the second icon, I'm going to be using favorite. Then let's say this is search. And lastly, this is person. And this is going to be favorites. This is going to be search. And the last one is going to be profile. So if we hit save now, we see that our bottom navigation bar appears. But right now we cannot click on these items because they are not clickable. So to make these items clickable, we need to define an index. So I'm going to say current index is equal to 0. And we need to put this inside our bottom navigation bar. So let's put current index inside current index. Then we also need to take care of onTap property. This would give us an index. So every time we click on an item, I'm just going to set a state and also put the current index inside my index property. So if you now hit save, now we are able to navigate between our items. But right now there is a problem, and the problem is that we don't have actual screens, and this is only our bottom navigation bar. So we need to go to body. Inside the body, I'm going to put a list of screens and display the screen with the current index. So let's define the list of screens here. You can put your actual screens, but I'm going to define a list of dummy screens, each with a center widget, and inside that we have a text like home, and it also has a style. Let's use a font size of 30. Also make sure this widget is constant, and I'm going to repeat it 3 other times. One for favorites, for search, and also profile. And if you now hit save, we already have our screen here. So if we click on any of these items, we can switch between different screens. Now I want to give some more styling to our bottom navigation bar to achieve the actual design. For that, I'm going to wrap my bottom navigation bar with the card widget. Pass an elevation of 6, and I also want to give some margin, and that's going to be a margin of 16 from all the sides. If you now hit save, it already looks a lot better. But I also want to give some color to each bottom navigation bar. For now you see that indicator color is the same for all of them, but we can actually specify one different color for each of them. So let's just put some comma to get the formatting right. And for each of them, I'm going to put a separate color. So let's say it has a color of purple. This one's got a color of orange. This is going to have a color of pink. And the last one is going to have a color of teal. So if you now hit save, or maybe even hot restart the application, now you can see that each item has its own color. But there are also other properties that we can modify. So come inside this Solimen bottom bar. we got a duration here, and I'm gonna say the duration of 1 second. So if we save the project right now, we see that the animation is acting slowly. So we also have other properties like this margin and also the item padding. So item padding is the padding between our indicator and also our text. So let's put a good padding here, and I'm gonna say this is gonna be a padding of 20. And now as you can see, our indicator has grown in size. You can also give it a padding of like 8, and this is gonna shrink. So this is basically everything about this project. See you in the next one.